Hi guys, Tom Morrison here, and you may have heard that you need to squat with your feet faced completely forwards. And in reality, this is not the case. Every squat's going to be different, and everyone's foot placement in their squat is going to be different based on a multitude of different factors. It could be that you have retroverted or antiverted hips, you have got the femur length, you have got tibia length, you have got your leg torso proportions to think about, your level of ankle dorsiflexion, asymmetrical femur heads. Wait. You can have asymmetrical femur heads? That means that one of your feet might have to turn out more than the other when you're squatting? Anywho, there is no perfect squat foot placement. You need to find the one that works best for you, and over time you can work towards a better position based on, does it feel more comfortable and is it more stable as well, rather than just trying to do something for the sake of doing it. The only reason you would really want to drastically change your foot placement is if you're getting a nip sensation in your hip, or you're just getting a lot of pain or back pain, or it's just hindering your overall training. The big thing about foot placement as well to consider is your torso position and where the weight is in relative to your body position. So let's look at some examples. The front squat or the goblet squat is probably the best place to play around with your foot position. So the nature of the squat is because the weight is in the front, you're going to find it more and easier to keep your chest more upright in the squat. But the main things that you want to think about as you're actually doing this is, do you feel like you're loading your hips, or are you using the weight to help you to get down into a lower position? So Jenny could quite easily just relax everything off and use the weight to keep her upright and even sit right down in the bottom. That's not going to be great. It's not something we really want to train, but it gives her a chance to sort of see, where do my knees feel good, where do my feet feel good, and where do I feel like I can generate power from. So if Jenny picks a position of her feet that she likes, really thinks about grabbing the ground with her toes and trying to make a good arch, and then pulls herself down into her hips. She doesn't just drop down in the bottom, she pulls herself down. Your hips should almost feel tighter as you do this. This is called torque. This is what you're after when you're squatting. It should feel like a position of strength. You should feel almost a stiffness there, and you're not just relaxing down into the bottom and hoping for the best. So the front squat is a great way to play around with that. What you'll notice if Jenny switches things up to a back squat, if she puts the bar up and over, she's going to probably find there that a different stance might feel a bit better because her torso is now going to be leaning down forward that little bit more. Most people will generally find a little bit more of a wider stance and is nicer in this one, or you may even find that you're able to actually have your feet that little bit more straighter because it's more of a hip loaded position, okay? So there's not going to be as much weight going through the knees, say, and the quads, for example, as what there would be for a goblet squat or a front squat. So to take the bar out of the equation for a second quickly, if Jenny just grabs a kettlebell, you can start to use the kettlebell in the goblet squat position to really mess around with your foot placement and your foot stance and see what feels best to you, and also see what doesn't feel nice to you as well. So whatever way you want to hold the kettlebell, that's absolutely fine. Just see where you can sit down to and shimmy yourself around, and like I said, feel strong. Don't just relax in the bottom or feel like you're just trying to stretch with it. See where you feel strong. Feel where you are most in control of the weight. So this is the safest way to play around with things and see where your knees feel best, where your hips feel best, la la la. So taking that away for a bit of time now, we're going to go into an example of the overhead squat. So what you can always see as well, so we're talking in the likes of weightlifters here, is that your foot placement may actually change depending on the demands of the movement. So where you may see when you unrack something in a back squat, you might have a completely different stance to what you have when you're doing an overhead squat because of the torso demands. And that's why a lot of times, if you look at a lot of lifters, you'll almost see that if Jenny can just go straight on for me and face the camera straight on, if she goes down into her overhead squat, you may see that their knees are actually caved in a bit more than they normally would be than they whenever they're back squatting. So Jenny has great flexibility, so she can keep really good alignment. But what you'll see with some people maybe having to compensate somewhere in order to keep their chest upright is the knees will have to come in a little bit. That's where weightlifting shoes come into the equation to help there as well. But it's actually an absolutely fine position to be in because you're never going to be snatching as much as you're back squatting. So it's in relative terms of your overall strength, not that bad. So it's not to say, you know, squatting like this is a great thing to do, but you have to think about what you're trying to achieve with the movement. And if you're trying to chase like the flexibility of Jenny, for example, whenever you're someone who has a completely different hip shape, you know, you are just chasing the wrong squat. You want to find something that's a bit better to you, and that may need to be a little bit higher. So if Jenny brings herself up, you may only be able to get a wider foot squat with the toes pointed out and just be able to break parallel, and that's keeping you in a safer position rather than you trying to chase something that you just can't attain over time, you're better to play around, see what feels best to you with these drills, and find the squat that works best for you. If you find you have a mobility limitation, you just can't get down at all, then you need to work on your mobility. Specific mobility method is a great way to do that because it's going to assess each hip individually. So find the squat that you feel strong in. Don't be afraid to turn your feet out a little bit if you need to, or even over time, like I said, if you are working through things and over time your feet start to come in a little bit more, that's great. But like I said, it's not an essential thing. Find the squat that works best for you, it's pain-free, that you feel like you can load over time and it isn't giving you any problems, and you're gonna have a lot more fun with your training. Okay, guys? Just beware to not fall down the rabbit hole of madness when it comes to squats. Sometimes the answer to improving your squat is to just squat more and just pay attention whenever you're doing it. If you're really struggling with your overhead squat, make sure to check out our How to Fix Your Overhead Squat video. It'll give you a couple of nice variations that include squat movements to help you to improve your overhead squat. So if it is something you're struggling with, make sure to check that out, and happy squatting.